Women, what are some questions you've always wanted to ask men, but were too embarrassed? My first long-term relationship started that way in college. We had hung out and flirted a bunch, culminating in us watching a movie at her apartment and her shoving me against the wall when I was about to leave afterward. It was a shock, it was a surprise, and I'll never forget that night so long as I live. Girl nearly half my size just took her shot. As a tall guy, a woman taller than me would be weird at first, but not an issue. Honestly, I think there is no difference between men and women when it comes to their partner's weight. Some people don't care at all, but most people probably have a point where they don't find it particularly appealing. And the hair thing really doesn't matter. I prefer less, but again, it's not an issue. How often do men want to be hugged? Does it feel clingy if a girl offers it every now and then? Edit. This thread felt like a survey XD, and reading all the comments, I think the conclusion is 97% of men loves it and most of them are really starved of hugs. 2% of men don't mind if they are offered. 1% don't like it. Thanks to all the men out there for opening up. The girls just shower your soul with the hugs. They love it as much as we do. For the rest, 3% just ask for their consent. Do guys really appreciate a woman that makes the move, whether you are newly dating or married for years? I want him to feel wanted by me and I want to convey that. Or do guys feel it could threaten them a little bit? I know it sounds weird and maybe old school, but I have always wondered what the answer is. Thanks, Edit. Wow, so many great responses. Thank you all. I am planning a special night for my show, so thanks to all the great suggestions on here. I'm going to make the night all about him. Do guys really appreciate a woman that makes the move, whether you are newly dating or married for years? Appreciate. Most of us are desperate for that. Also, I am not sure about the accuracy of this statement, but the relationships where the women made the first move, according to stats, 86% of them ended in marriages. Also, it feels great to be wanted by someone when all your life you have been doing for everyone else. Be the big spoon. Scalp massage. Back rub. Not necessarily a massage, either. Next time y'all are watching TV in bed or on the couch, let him lay his head on your chest or lap, and run your fingers through his hair, or just pet his back like a dog. Even better if he's shirtless and you can lightly scratch his back. May not seem like much, but it makes a big impact on us, even if we may not immediately show it. For me, it slows my mind, helps me stop thinking for a while and process the here and now so much better. I haven't seen any other responses that mention this, so I'll throw it out there. I've had more than one attractive friend bemoan her lack of male attention when she goes out, but she also keeps herself surrounded by a pack of 5 or 6 friends at all times. Sometimes it's less about your beauty being intimidating and more about, do I have to walk up to this whole group and have 8 people judge me instead of just one? I commented this under another comment in this thread, so this is a direct cut and paste. Absolutely. True story. There was this really pretty girl in my friend group, all young 20-somethings, in San Diego. We'd hang out, go to parties, go to concerts, go to the beach, etc. I never even considered asking her out because she was way out of my league. One night she and I were the last of our group at the bar. She has no car, so I offer her a ride home. She invites me in for a beer. Cool. We're watching late night TV and she leans her head on my shoulder. Hey, fine. We're buds, right? Then her hand is on my thigh. Weird. I turn to look at her and she's looking in my eyes. I ask if she's okay and she says she'd be better if I kissed her. WTF. She's like a 9 and I'm a 6 at best. Maybe a Scranton 8. But, fuck yeah, we make out for a bit. But when I go to cop a feel, she breaks it off and says, we've both had a lot to drink. Maybe you should sleep here tonight. I see I've blown it and say, sure, thanks. She heads to the bedroom and I kick off my shoes and stretch out on the couch. A couple of minutes go by and she comes back and says, are you coming? What the actual fuck? Yeah, that was December 12, 1981. We married April 3, 1982. Still going strong. If it wasn't for her, never would have happened. What hurts the balls is sudden pressure. For example, if I am running away from my neighbor Jim who just caught me shitting in his lawn, my balls are gently slapping against my leg, which does not hurt. However, when Jim catches me and kicks me in the balls, that is a very sudden application of a very high amount of pressure, which hurts quite a lot. What does it feel like to get hit accidentally, not kicked purposefully but like, flicked, etc., in the balls? A sharp and intense pain that radiates into the lower abdomen. If I had to describe it, it'd be like a super intense and sharp stomach ache. On the balls themselves, you probably know already. Haven't you ever taken a hit to the ovaries or kidney? It's pain to an organ. A good ball scratch feels quite pleasant actually, not really even in a sexual way. Just in a scratch behind a dog's ears sort of way. As for playing with them, juggling them around and such, I don't guess it's particularly painful as long as you're not treating them like ping pong balls, but no real pleasure from it either. At least for me. As for what it feels like to get heat in the balls, pretty much like someone punched you in the stomach as hard as they could and knocked the wind out of you. Not pleasant at all. Usually it take a pretty good hit to cause ball pain. You're not going to do it by just brushing against them or bumping into them, though I have been really sore down there a few times after a marathon sex session the night before. That constant slapping can do a number on them. Serious question, men. Would it bother you if a girl had self-harm scars? How far along in the relationship would you want to know about / see them? Edit. This is the first time I've had a comment become this big and I honestly don't know how to reply to everyone. However, I truly want to thank everyone who replied as this ease is probably my biggest insecurity. Also, I am okay, like I said. They're scars from when I was younger and wasn't as comfortable with myself. I am not still self-harming and I don't have plans to ever continue. It was a dark part of my life that I never want to go back to. I asked the question because I've never been in a serious relationship before, so I've never had to tell a guy. I don't usually talk about them. My family is super conservative, so they don't even know. So I wasn't sure what the proper etiquette would be. To anyone with the same fear I had, read the comments. Most guys don't care. They care about you and your well-being. Hi, how are you? Edit. I've noticed most of you don't feel well. Now that the post is one day old, there will be much less people saying it. But if you feel the need to talk, you can reach out to me or probably some other amazing folks in the comments. Feel free to post an R. Venting, R, Offmecast and other subs. There will be people able to listen to you and help you if you want. Stay safe and take care of yourself. Illy Internet Stranger 3. Did your friends actually invited me or are you just being nice to not make me feel left out? Edit, just context. My boyfriend brings me around his friends all the time and I always have a nice time. They are all really nice to me. I don't really take much space because I'm shy and also they don't speak the same language as me. All. Just saw a video of guys talking about how much they hate when their friends bring their GFS with them and it got me thinking, what if they actually do hate me? Lol. Edit 2. Thanks people. I didn't mean this question to be very serious. Seems like it all depends on just being authentic and nice towards each other. I understand it's important to have guys only time, as I also love girls only time, so I don't have problems with that. Just wanted to hear other people's perspective. Thanks, Miles. It all depends on the relationship. If you are chill, don't make everything about you, or kick up a huge fuss, then I am usually fine with you. What gets you uninvited to the next gathering is if you make a big deal out of nothing. If something actually serious happened, it's fine to freak, or have to be the center of attention. One of my buddies brought this girl along to a movie and she talked on her phone the whole time. Uninvited, the next girl came out for supper with us and started crying and freaking out because her favorite Instagram model shut down their page. Uninvited, the next girl got a call that her brother was hit by a car. Totally justifiable freak out. We dropped everything and took her to the hospital. I never wanted kids because I had a painful childhood. I've got a 3-year-old daughter and she's awesome. I like that she likes a lot of the things I do. I'm a wilderness skills instructor and she knows lots of plants already. If she wants to learn knitting, I'll teach her. If she wants to learn friction fires, I'll teach her that too. My wife and I were expecting a boy, but we lost him. That was fucking awful. We are expecting again and it's a boy. I'm pretty excited for that. A couple of empathetic little badasses running around sounds great. For the first 2 pregnancies I was scared. Now I just trust the universe and that we are a good team. Edit. Wow. Thanks to everyone for the support. I just found out this morning that it's going to be a boy. I can't compare it to anything. The actual balls don't hurt. It's like this pain that shoots up into your abdomen. So maybe taking a blunt knife and ramming it up in between your balls and anus. Just this long blunt knife right up in there. You know it's going to go away eventually. But for 30 good seconds you feel immense pain. It fucking hurts so much. Edit. I'm going to expand on this. It's not just from underneath. It's like someone stabbing you with a blunt knife right in the belly button as well. Edit 2. Also by blunt knife, I meant sharp knife, but without the bleeding. So an invisible, sharp knife that leaves no lasting damage nor scars. Edit 3. Okay, I was referring to a light to moderate attack on the nuts. What you guys are describing is an absolute bludgeoning, which, yes, would suck. Seek professional help if that's the case. What happens to your balls when you run? Are they just banging around? Do they stick between your thighs? Do they end up tucked? I've been dying to know. Thanks. Update. Did not expect this to blow. Thank you for the awards and all of the insightful and valuable information. For most answers I received, I had more questions which were answered before I could even ask them. I can now say that I know what happens to your balls when folks are in motion or stationary. Again, thanks y'all. This had been bugging me for a while lol. What do you think about C-section scars? I have one and I think it's ugly. It juts out and there's a shelf. I'm otherwise quite fit looking. I'm just self-conscious about it. Edit. Wow, didn't expect this comment to gain so much traction. Thank you all kind strangers. You've made me feel so much better, confident about my body. It is a modern miracle that my kid and I are still alive today. So that is something to be very grateful about. I've always thought scars are badass. They're like tattoos except they're earned instead of bought. Any cool character in a fantasy movie has some odd scar and that's how you know that character kicks ass. My wife's C-section scar isn't even big or anything. Surgeons were on their game, but even if it was big, it just means she did all the work to make our son. She's that badass character in my movie. This one is tough. On the one hand, you'll see tons of guys talking about how they hate that they're rarely complimented and how they remember the few times they have been fondly. On the other hand, because it is so rare, it's also pretty easy to spin it up into something more than it is, and that's for a generally emotionally healthy guy. For the guys out there who aren't, you're running a risk. Maybe your best bet is to go with something like I do not want to have sex with you but you do look really nice in that shade of blue even though I do not want to have sex with you. A guy friend told me that all guys are capable of turning off their minds. Like, if you had a bad day you could just shut that off for a moment and distract yourself pretty easily with something else. And that's why men are less likely to constantly talk about their feelings and become emotional. Edit. Wow. So, apparently he's right in a way. Now I'm wondering if there's some kind of scientific explanation for this or if I'm just a weird human girl who can't just blow myself to stop thinking. I'm jealous. Edit 2. Whoa, this got a lot more attention than I thought it would. Thank you all for your responses. To summarize what I have learned, it seems it is a learned coping mechanism most men can do, but it is not necessarily specific to men, just more common I think. To clarify where I come from, I personally feel more stressed when I am trying to avoid something that is on my mind. If I personally force distraction, I end up being out of it 50%+ of the time and miserable all the time. My ex couldn't understand why I got pissed every time he tried to divert the serious, emotional conversation to something more uplifting, but that's just how I function. Smile, I do not speak for all women, I may just be weird. Okay, this is a question I've literally had for years. Kinda a weird one, but bear with me. If a dude gets a boner while just cuddling or whatever, does that always mean that they are actually in the mood? Like, I always wondered if it ever goes up. But you don't even wanna frick a ha-ha-ha. I never want to assume that a guy actually wants to have sex. Just cause his knob does. I'm genuinely confused by penises lmao. Okay, I feel like some people are misinterpreting my question. I'm aware that random stiffies can come out of thin air, but I'm asking more about whether or not it can happen, and the dude not even be down for it. You know, edit. Alright, the consensus seems to be, it doesn't mean that they are specifically wanting that, but they usually won't be opposed to a dance with no pants if their schlong is ready to go. Got it. Correct me if I'm wrong. Ha ha ha. Thank you to all the boys who are giving me explanations. Well, I've enjoyed reading them. There is a lot of pressure to perform in a traditional nuclear family. It's up to us to keep everyone safe, make sure everything is in working order, vehicles/home maintenance, be emotionally supportive, and again traditionally sacrifice to make sure ends meet, working shit jobs, putting everyone's needs in front of your own, etc. Having a penis is kinda dope, especially when spending time outdoors, just pissing on everything, trees, fire, ant beds, ... you name it, I've probably pissed on it. I wouldn't use the term proud, it's just anatomy. It is cool though. It's like a lifetime friend that gets you into a lot of trouble but is always there when you're ready to play with it. Being expected to make the first move is my struggle. If the girls who are interested in me made the first move, I would have had many more dates in the past. The itching at the base and pubic area and especially our balls can be uncomfortable and annoying. Of course, I don't wish I didn't have one, and yes, having a penis is a good feeling, especially when women compliments that it is big. To give you a comparison of how having one feels like, when it's soft, it's no different than, like, say, your earlobe. But when it's erected, you have this tension inside your groin area, and the touching of the erected penis is probably the closest I can think of in comparison, like touching your erected nipples. It's fine as long as it's not a full-time job. Some people like to provide emotional support. It helps them to feel needed and wanted in a relationship. I have some friends that are the absolute rock and stabilizing factor in a romantic relationship with women with mental health issues. Some guy friends, on the other hand, are too unstable or needy to provide help for others. I think the limit is so different depending on the person. I've been with women where there was nearly a weekly breakdown, and it was actually okay because we worked through it and there were other aspects of the relationship that were fulfilling. I felt like it was okay because I knew I was contributing something to her and the relationship, and she wasn't hateful or mean. Sometimes a guy just likes to have a giant truck because they're fun to have. Tonka trucks were rad to play with as kids, and some of us took that as adults and lifted up our trucks and put big old tires on them purely because we like seeing it in the driveway. Sometimes it's impractical, sure, but we're generally not compensating for anything. The thought process is simply he truck big, and then we smile like idiots while standing in the driveway staring at it. Loud exhaust is a little more annoying, but the thought process is the same. Cargo Sometimes those things are in service towards better performance on or off the road, and that's a whole different animal. Lot more thought goes into those mods, but the stupid grinning at the sheer ridiculousness of the build is still there. So, this is a little contested, but I think what I'm about to say is as accurate as I can get it. In general, to prevent things like prostate cancer and other problems, men are recommended to masturbate 2-3 times per week, at least. But that's general advice and may or may not work for an individual. But not doing that doesn't stop things from working. You don't get sperm backups. You don't get uncomfortable from not doing it. You're going to have more problems if you change your rate drastically than anything else. If you're a frequent masturbator and then suddenly stop for a month, that raises your risk of prostate problems down the road significantly. I know some frequent masturbators. I know some people who never masturbate at all because of their religious upbringing. Yes, this is something I have talked to my guy friends about. It's weird and sometimes uncomfortable, but I think it's important to talk about, and it generally doesn't have a feeling of discomfort to not do it.